Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we thank you for today. Lord, we thank you for each and every one that is listening to me under the sound of my voice. Oh, God, move by your spirit on today. Touch the lives of the listeners. Touch my life, God. Be glorified on today. Lord, we thank you, Father, for your Holy Spirit, Father, who lives in us, Father. Lord, we thank you, Father, that for changing the course of history, God. Lord, we thank you, Father, that our life, Father, would be meaningless without you, God. It would be meaningless without you, God. Lord, we thank you, Father, for you, God, for breaking the cycle of brokenness and bondage in our lives, Father. Lord, we so grateful, Father. I'm so grateful, Father, that you are mine, God, and I am yours, God. Help me to never take that for granted, oh God. Lord, from now on, God, I want to display your love, God, on this broadcast, Father. And Lord, I want to live a life that celebrates you and the life that's so pleasing to you, oh God. Lord, I just lift your name on high and I glory and magnify your name. And Lord, as I always say, God, Lord, because you that I live, move, and have I been, Father. And Lord, I just lift your name on high and I glory and magnify your name, Father. I thank you, Father, for today's guest, Father, Miss Mamie Jackson and her business, oh God, and for her record label, God. And Lord, I just thank you, Father, for what she have, Father, in the platform that she stands on, oh God. Lord, move by your spirit, Father, on today's broadcast. Lord, I thank you, Father, for for her life, health, and strength, God. And Lord, I just thank you, and I lift your name on high in glory and magnify your name, because it is in Jesus' name that we pray. Amen. Y'all, it's time for an all-new broadcast of the RH3 Show. Let's get it.
Live from North Carolina, it's the RH3 Show.
I wasn't scared to go over there.
Look, I do this for nobody but my co-host. Because God first, then my co-host.
I done been doubted, I done been counted out, I done been overlooked.
Because your listeners are, you know, international, they're worldwide.
The RH3 Show starts right now.
I gotta pray because he set me free. Christ said he paid free me at Calvary. I'm gonna dance if there's no stopping me. Don't ever change, cause I...
What's going on, family? What's going on, everybody? What's going on, my people? Y'all. Listen, I'm gonna tell y'all something. It's time for a kitchen table talk. We're going to get that started before we get anything else started. So, you know what? Y'all already know who I am. Y'all already know who I be. But if you don't, I'm going to tell y'all. I'm your boy Rufus. I'm your boy Ren. And I am the host of this great platform. I'm the host of the RH3 Show. Pull up a chair. Let's have a conversation. It is time for our kitchen table talk. Let's go ahead. All right, pull up a chair. Let's have a conversation. It's time for our kitchen table talk. Y'all, it's time for our kitchen table talk, and this is where I give you all my honest, my unscripted opinion on what I've been doing. Well, I get transparent on what I've been doing, and I just, you know, not what I've been doing, or, you know, we just have a real open conversation on a lot of stuff, and so, yes. How y'all been doing on today, y'all? I came in at what, round one to get the day started, because I really wasn't going to come in to get the day started. It really was going to be a best up, but they said, no, you got to guess. I'm like, oh, really? I forgot. But it's all good because I love doing what I'm doing. And well, let me back that up. I wasn't gonna come in today because I have a big day on tomorrow, and then we'll talk about it on Friday. And so, I thought my guest was going to come on Friday. And I'm like, okay, good. I have Wednesday to be off and Thursday to be off. And I'm like, no. And even on tomorrow, I still may peep in. So, you know, just chill for a minute, all right? Just chill. Nah. But how y'all been doing on today? I had a long day, and so I'm like, I had to take a break, and I had to run up here and and do my thing, and you know, hey, I'm empty-handed. I just got my book, and I'm empty-handed, and then the guest gonna call in a few. And we're gonna rock it out. And so, yeah. We're gonna do the thing. And so, yeah. Great show on, that we've been rocking out and doing on this entire week. We've been talking to the fellas and even the ladies on how to think like a man of God. Well, thinking like a man of God. And fellas, becoming a man of God, and ladies, understanding, you know, men of God and men of valor, love, honesty, and integrity. And so, yeah. And, yes. And so, that's on that. And so, yeah. That's what we're gonna continue on that. And so we're going to get into, we talked about, first we gave an introduction on Monday, and then yesterday we spoke on the aspect of men of valor. And today we're going to talk about men of love, because we always speak on that, because, you know, I harp on, the love part. But yeah, we're going to talk about all of that. But not really much been rocking on today, y'all. Y'all, it's just been a lot, y'all. Keep your host, your boy, in prayer. Keep your boy, your host, in prayer, because I can't wait till I let y'all know about this, because I can tell y'all, but I want what I want to post on Instagram be a little surprise, because it's been creative. And so it's something that I've done before. But I want to be successful in it. And even if I don't, I'm like, okay, well, I tried. Because I wanted to give up on it earlier this week. I wanted to give up on it even yesterday. You know, I wanted to give up on it yesterday. And so, like I said, even if y'all follow me, very few. I don't even let some of y'all into my personal life, but very few of you all follow me on my personal, you know, accounts and pages and whoop the wop, and know, you know, what's going on. And so I'm like, okay, yeah. But anyway, that's that. And yeah, and so that's all I have for you. We have no inside scoop. Inside scoop will be back on it may be back on tomorrow, but if not, it'll be back on Friday, and I'll just be writing notes up until Friday. Oh, I will talk about it on Friday, but there is, I think he's 55, But there is a 55-year-old man who back in, I think it was back in September, married his 18-year-old goddaughter from Jacksonville, Florida. You dirty, I'm about to say dog, but there it is. That was wrong, bruh. Wrong. 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 Okay. Anyway, let me move on. 55-year-old married his 18-year-old goddaughter. And he even, you know, had some dealing with her mama. I mean, sick individual. Dude. But anyway, y'all, keep it where you got it. Coming up next is our special guest on today, Miss Mamie L. Jackson. She's on the phone. She's here to talk about her record label. She got a nice song out. We're going to premiere that on the RH3 show on today. And it is a great platform that she's on. And that song, ooh, jazz song, it's about freedom and you know, the time that we're in. Y'all, you don't want to miss it. You miss a day, you miss a lot. So keep it where you got it. More of the RH3 show is coming up next.
Hi, it's Nina
and my man Red.
Stay tuned. More of the RH3 show is coming up next.
To be honest, sometimes I wonder if it's come time to pack it in. If I've given my best and there's nothing left, so my best days are at an end. Oh. And I remember that you would never let me face what's next alone. I know that you're keeping me strength when I'm weak and expect me to carry on. I know that the Lord is preparing me for great things. But on days when it's hard to believe, hey, I wanna live right now, life upon me. Claim every blessing you have for me. Sometimes it feels like I'm too way down, running to fly but stumbling to the ground. Yeah, and I remember that you would never ever leave your child behind. Oh no, you're with me right where I should be, and the reasons I revealed in time. I know that the Lord is preparing me for great things I have yet to see. But on days when it's hard to believe, I'm gonna sing that one more time. When I'm anxious and lose my way,
feel like gold
with all I need to keep moving, making sure that you are pleased. Yeah. Oh, I know that the Lord is preparing
me
for great.
our first guest we have on, and it is an honor and privilege to be back with you all for this second break. If you will, please welcome to the show Mamie Jackson. She's the founder and the CEO of 152 Street Recordings, and she has also shared the stage with the likes of Dr. Maddie Moss Clark, the mother of the Clark sisters, as well as the Clark sisters, and many more, just to name a few. And you will know more about her as she speaks with us. And please welcome to the RH3 show, Miss Mamie Jackson. Mamie, how are you?
I'm fine, Rufus. How are you today?
I'm doing well. Welcome to the RH3 show. It is an honor and privilege to have you on the broadcast on today.
It's a pleasure. Likewise. Thank you, sir.
Yes. And so before we get into the interview, please let everyone know more about who Mamie is.
Well, let's see. Mamie has been on the scene for a long time.
Mm-hmm.
I was born at February 24th, 1960. And at 7 years old, my mom caught me in my bedroom directing an invisible choir, and I thought I was going to have a choir one day. And so at 10 years old, I started a group of five, and then at 12, I started my first choir at 150 voices, and then at 13, I started another choir, and that was 100 voices, and that's when I met Dr. Maddie Moss.
Mm-hmm.
And from there, it just went on, and I work with artists as Isaac Douglas, Thomas Whitfield, Dr. Charles Fogg, and so many others. And then the platform on the R&B chart, The Temptations, featuring Dennis Edwards, Review, Midnight Star, Howard Hewitt, Glenn Jones, Del DeBarge, and just to name a few.
Yes, and so that is a great lineage and a great resume of these artists that you've been, you know, working with. And so what would you say your title in the industry would be?
Well, I'm the founder and CEO of my own label.
Uh-huh.
After dealing with other close to receiving other record contracts from different labels, I've learned that he is, you know, very political.
Mm-hmm.
And so at this time, I just decided to go independent.
Independent, right. Right. And so with these artists that you've worked with, you know, of course, I've you know, did some studying as the host and you know, the material and, you know, the you know, the work that you have given me, your resume that you've given me, the what you've appeared on, you know, on television. Did you appear with these artists or you appeared on yourself? Let them know, you know, the platforms that you appeared on television or whatever, and the work that you've done, you know, with these artists.
Well, on platform, on BET, Bobby Jones Gospel, we were his featured guests. I met him at the park for Mahalia Jackson in Los Angeles. And I gave him a tape for his group to sing it, but he wanted my group to appear.
Mm-hmm.
On that. And basically, with Dr. Clark and the Clark, I met him in church.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of this was church, but the R&B artists were more on the platform for. I live in Dayton, Ohio, so U92 radio station, it was like the Black Culture Festival and music festivals.
Mm-hmm.
The venues, yes, that we share stages with the R&B artists.
Exactly. That is a blessing. And so And so I tell folks that, hey, there's nothing wrong to you know, put out there of what you're doing and speak of what God has put these platforms that God has put you on, and you know, let them know, hey, look, this is what God has done, and not my, you know, not my doing. And people tell it, well, that's, you know, bragging it. No, this is what God is doing. And so every chance I get, I'm going to tell folks of where I've been at, you know.
Right, didn't he say go out into the world and preach his gospel?
Exactly. And not really preaching, and people think it's preaching and putting out the word. No, preaching is letting folks know and telling folks the goodness of what God has done. And so, exactly.
That's a blessing, you know. And when we did the New York International Music Festival, there was a gospel platform, and you know, Rufus, it was so touching to me. There was a young lady that couldn't get no more than 16 years old. She came down the aisle and stood through every song we sung. We sung six songs, and she danced in the aisle all by herself. And that was a blessing to me. And God showed me where your music, that the lyrics that I've given you, is touching the heart of not just the old, but the young. And that touched me so. And when we got off the stage, she actually did. I had a picture, and I signed it for her and gave it to her. And it was very touching. And other people were coming up, and they were like, we didn't know if that was gospel or what.
Mm-hmm.
So that let me know that, you know, just to do what God has called me to do out of the church is a blessing. That's why I call my record label 157 Street Records, because it's a street ministry.
Right.
It touches those who are lost and don't know him.
Exactly.
Yes.
Exactly. And so, exactly, and that's what, you know, what I read about even in your press kit, you know, what you said about what your platform is, you know, to present the music box with anointing, and you know, producing with the, you know, the results of that anointing or whatever. And so it's really good for that. And so I love it. I really love it. Mm-hmm. Tell us about your brand new single that's coming out, that you have out, the Freedom and Justice for All, and about who's all on that and who produced it, and this, who's on the music for that.
All right. Well, the Freedom and Justice for All remix is the anthem for social justice.
Mm-hmm.
And this remix features a collaboration of friends, of infectious energy and sounds, of Bullset Ingredients. And the music was performed by Keith Harrison of the Daz Band, and added horns and keys by Billy Beck of the Ohio Player. And my production, MLJ Street Sound, produced it.
So, tell us how all of that came about with the production and the meaning behind it.
Well, I wrote the song Freedom in 1990.
Mm-hmm.
I recorded it in 91, and that's around the time when Rodney King was beaten by police brutality of March in 1991. But I remixed it. God had me putting in the archives, and he told me to bring it out for 2021 after the Mark Floyd situation. And it was so touching that when my friend and I was in the studio remixing the track,
mm-hmm.
that was the day of the verdict guilty for George Floyd.
Mm-hmm.
And recorded at the mixed and recorded at the same studio I recorded it 21 years ago.
Wow. And so that's, I love it. And so what we're going to do is present it to the audience after the interview. And so that, it's needed. And so especially in the time that we're in. And they'll love it. And so what I'm going to do is I'll post the on our social media platforms. And so after the interview, and even I think what the social media assistant is going to post the image for the that you shared with us of the art. Who did that artwork of that Freedom and Justice for All poster?
My great niece, Jennifer Salone. She's in college up there, Bowling Green. And she captured the image that I wanted to portray, and I loved her outcome of it.
Mm-hmm. And so is that the album cover for the song?
Yes, that's a single cover.
Yes. And so is that going to be a the song is going to be released on an album? Is that?
I will put it on the album. But right now I put it out as a single first.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm in the studio working on more material to follow it.
Right, right. I love it. I love it. And I love jazz music. And so, do you have any more music that's coming out in your through your music group?
Yes, but not right now. I'm still pushing this one to get this message out because it is so needed for what's
yes.
going on today.
Yes. Yes.
You know, and we're still, you know, over 400 years, and we're still fighting for freedom. We're still marching in the streets, hollering, no justice, no peace. It's time for change. It's time for all change on this because we are human beings just like everyone else. And God created all equal.
And it's crazy that, you know, even in 2000 and, 21 that we're in, that we're still doing this,
yeah.
You know. It really is. And so, you know, even for little children to ask, you know, if you were back, and it kind of, you know, disheartening and hurtful that, you know, children to ask, even me, and I'm 39, were you back in the slavery days? And I'm like, baby, you know, you in it too, you know, that, you know, here now, and it's not as bad as it's in, but, you know, you're in, you witnessing it happening all over again, you know.
Yes, Rufus, they're facing it too. What's so sad about it is they have taken Black history out of the schools, and it's sad that our family structure is not like it how it used to be when I was coming up.
Right.
When we had family. So you know what I'm saying? And we had it in our school system. And these children really don't know who they are.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's not being taught at home. Charity is taught at home, and then it's spread abroad.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so we have to every, and I love you for this platform that you have.
Thank you.
We can use this to illuminate the minds of our children to let them know, because my God baby, who was 9 at the time, she goes to a diverse school, and this young boy pulled a knife on her in her classroom.
That's crazy.
And I was stabbed, you know. And, you know, of course, he's a little white boy, and my God baby's Black.
Mm-hmm.
And so I have to tell her, you know, we're being targeted. Now they're targeted. Now the children, this poison has entered into the hearts of the children.
Mm-hmm.
And they need to know that our struggle will continue till Jesus comes, but we have to learn how to deal with it.
Mm-hmm. Yep, have to learn how to deal with it.
Mm-hmm. Yes, it's really sad, and it's a heart condition, Rufus.
It is. It really is.
Yes, a heart condition, you know, Rufus. And I just this song, Freedom. I just pray that it illuminates the hearts and mind of men to change and to know that God is love, and we can't keep using Bible scriptures for our agenda.
You're right.
It's taken out of context.
You're exactly right.
God is love. He's not a God of hate.
Mm-hmm. And we got to love everybody. And no, you know, no matter, you know, and I hate to say this. And so, you know, people even, you know, those who, you know, those who have been, you know, been in you know, churches who have been taught wrong, you know, no matter where we are in life and no matter, you know, who we are or whatever, old thinking is, you know, is old thinking. Love everybody. Let God deal with all the what they dealing with. Still love them where they at. You know, love them where they at. And you know, once we leave here, let God judge them with what they have dealt with. But where we at, God, you know, God gonna let God tell us to love them, you know, in spite of and because of. And then let God deal with them. But my place is just to love them, you know, in spite of. And, you know, we have to.
Yes, and we need a platform to talk about this.
Mm-hmm.
Like, why do you hate us so when the same God made you made me?
Exactly. Exactly.
Yes. God is love. It mm-hmm. doesn't matter what form we are. We come from Him.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Is there any final encouraging word you want to say to the listening audience before we close out on the interview?
Well, I just want to thank everyone and just pray that everyone is safe. And pray about, you know, there's a thing about should I take the vaccination and should I not. Just pray about it.
Exactly.
You know, because over 600,000 people have died and still dying.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so let's stay safe and stay prayed up. And let's put Jesus back where He shouldn't have never left.
Exactly. Exactly.
Yes.
And so you can give your social media platforms and where they could purchase the album, the single, if should they want to, and you know where they can find Mamie Jackson and your record label.
Okay, thank you, Rufus. You can find Freedom and Justice Remix by 152nd Street Records at iTunes, Spotify, Amazon, Pandora, Apple Music, and Deezer. And you can also go to our website, 152strecords.com, and join our mailing list so we can stay connected. You can find, if you want to hear the whole single, it's on YouTube under 152nd Street Records. You can find me at Twitter, at Mamie L. Jackson, Facebook.com, world/world 152 Street Records, IG at J. Mamie L. And that's it, Ruth.
All right. Thank you so much. And here is Mamie Jackson and the single Freedom and Justice for All Remix coming up next right here on the RH3 Show. You're more than welcome. Keep it, you all, where you got it. I'll talk to you all in a minute.
Yes, it does. Black and white. human disease keeps taunting me. Our history still fighting for freedom.
Everybody, this is your boy Rufus, your boy Red, host of the RH3 show, and I want to get on here to encourage you all during this time of stay at home, during this time of quarantine, during this time of isolation, during this pandemic, or whatever situation that you may be going through, know that God will see you through. Know that God will see you through. And how can you get through this? You may ask. You may just sitting and pondering and wondering, what can I do to get through this? Love everybody. Love each other. Love God and love yourself and love other people beyond words. That's all it is. And also, most important, listen to your leaders. Listen to your leaders. The Bible does say about listening to the voice and the instruction of your leaders. But also to inject that, listening to the leaders, also listen to the Holy Spirit. Have discernment as well. So, hey, listen to them. Stay home. Stay close with your family. All right? Learn and build with your family. Whenever you're at home with your family, look, have fun with them. Play games. Play boy games. Learn each other. Love each other. And, hey, be there for them, all right? Stay home. Use it as family time. Use it as growth. And study in the Word and watch TV and make this an enjoyable time for you all. Because they always say that a strong family builds a strong community. And a strong community builds a strong city, state, nation, and world. You get what I'm saying? All right. This is your boy Red, host of the RH3 show. For more about the broadcast and the times that I do come on, you can visit my website at therh3show.com. That was, and you heard from our special guest, Miss Mamie L. Jackson. Mamie, thank you so very much. Thank you so very much for coming on to the RH3 show. And that Freedom and Justice for All remix will be in rotation on the RH3 show and probably on the affiliate stations that the RH3 show is on, and maybe on our international flagship station as well. So be on the lookout for that, because I love jazz music, y'all. I love it. And so, y'all, if y'all will follow her, as you heard before she left the interview, follow her on her platforms or what have you. And so again, thank you so very much. It y'all It is a anthem for social justice, which was remixed the day of the guilty verdict for George Floyd. And so Mamie has a long rap sheet. She has a long resume that she have, and so she knows her stuff. She knows her stuff. And so keep it where you got it, y'all. Go to the website, therh3show.com, and vote for the people poll question. I vote for the people poll question that we got is going to continue on to the end of the week, and hopefully on Friday we will give you the results, or on Monday we'll give you the results. But yeah, keep it where you got it. More of the RH3 show is coming up next. We got the Real Talk with Rufus discussion. All right, be back in a moment.
Round the throne of the Lord, hear the elders say, at the feet of the King is a constant offering. Around the throne of the Lord, they never cease to sing. At the feet of the King, there's a common thing. They cry, holy, holy Lord. So we cry, holy, holy God. At the feet of my King, round the throne of the Lord, they never get tired of it. At the feet of King Jesus. So we cry, holy,
man soto na mama mandi. To the only wise God, yep, the only wise King you are, the only wise God, yeah. To the only wise King, yeah. The one who sits up on the throne,
to the only wise King.
And he cannot be removed.
To the only wise God.
You are the only one, Lord.
Real life, we show real love, and we also have real conversations, all from a Christian male perspective. It's the Real Talk with Rufus, right here on the RH3 Show.
All right, you all, we got about 11 minutes of the show, and so we're going to continue on with our topic discussion. You just heard from Todd Delaney with Around the Throne of the Lord, and hear the angels cry. Whatever he said, I just be slain whenever that song go on. And so that was Revelations 4. And we left off on yesterday, and I'm just skimming through. We're not going to do the whole entire book because I want you all to go out and get it. I want you all to go out and get it. And so what we're going to really do is close out the Men of Valor portion of the book. And yeah. And so we left off with talking about, you know, how... you know, what the man is and how he is a boy by birth, man by age, and a man of God, a gentleman, a man of valor, love, honesty, integrity by choice. And all of those are being a good choice. But, you know, one of the aspects of being a man of valor is that a man, you know, he's a man of war. And one thing about a, you know, ladies, and I want you all ladies to listen to this. A great thing about having a, and like I love using, and it's not a word that I am being funny and like pickish or whatever, but one word I love to hear somebody, and even my, you know, I love to hear the word mispronounced strong. I love hearing somebody say strong. I love it. And I just think it's so cute. And I love it. But if you have the alarms people, you know, they just wait in the evening. Well, of course, maybe because it's still hot or whatever. But I love to hear people say scrong. But ladies, if you have a real gentleman and, you know, whatever, one of his aspect to be a man of war, somebody to protect you and protect you and protect you and protect his family, you know, whatever. But when somebody think of the word war, they think of soldier and an army or whatever, somebody fighting or whoever. But there's two types of war. There's a spiritual war and there's a physical war. And so, you know, once you get this book, y'all gonna differentiate those type of two. But if somebody having a spiritual war, know that if it gets deep, he will have to go. If it gets deep and uncontrollable, thank you, Holy Spirit. If it gets deep and uncontrollable, I would say, like one of my apostles, and general in the faith, say, have a Bible in one hand and a therapist in another. Because if it's get uncontrollable, then yeah, take care of that. Take care of that, because you don't want to get so deep in the mind to where you having a war in your mind and you can't control that. And so that spiritual war is like, whew. And many times the enemy begin to suggest to your mind that you won't be able to make it, and you can't pay your bills and won't be able to buy your groceries and pay utilities, and you know, what would you do to fight this battle? And you know, you can stand on God's word and say, God shall supply all my needs according to his riches and glory. You know, that's where the Bible come in at, and stand on God's word. But then the devil can continue to filtrate and you know, plant things in your mind. And so I would suggest, you know, continue to pray and stand on God's word, and also seek therapy. Because, of course, you know, things can go on in your mind, but God, of course, you can stand on God's word and pray and ask God, okay, God, I need help. God, this, that, and the third. But, you know, you're going to need somebody to walk you through that. God is there with you. God is pushing you. Well, God, you know, of course you need God. Okay. Let me say this, and then, you know, we're going to move on and close out today's broadcast. I'll say this much to you. People will say you don't need no therapist. Okay. Say this. If there's no use for therapy, who did God bless that knowledge to? Why would it be a need for therapy? Huh? So you mean to tell me that if I should become a therapist, why would I need the office? Why would I want to become a therapist? If you're telling me that, you know, my clientele shouldn't come to me and, you know, whatever, God didn't give me this ability to help people. God didn't give me this ability to become a radio talk show host. God didn't give me this ability to do this, that, and the third. Come on now. God gave me the same skill to help this, that, and third person just as much as God gave you the skills to do what you do. So, yes, Bible in one hand and a therapist in another. So my suggestion would be Bible in one hand and a Christian therapist in another. A Bible in the one hand and a person of faith, a Christian faith in another. You can't tell me not to go to no therapist. I'm not saying, for me, but I may need help. So, yes, God going to direct me to a person that, you know, whatever. Come on here. Come on. So, yes. Is this you and asking you what should you do? What should they do to fight this battle? Stand on God's word, you know? That's a spiritual battle. And then a physical war is fighting with your hands, weapons. You know, I'm not suggesting that. But, you know, whatever. Your mouth. But in closing, that's spiritual battle. But, you know, many... just as David surrounded himself with like-minded men of God, you should do the same as also men that speak into your life and encourage you. Many times on this journey, God will use not only godly father, mother, grandfather, as y'all can hear the close of the broadcast the theme going or whatever. I gotta get up out of here because people come behind me. But godly friends will lift you up in prayer and also speak into your life. They should be able to pray with you, bind spirit of the enemy that you are fighting. And if you have a spouse or a Christian friend, she should be able to cover you and get into and fight with you. But we'll talk about that a little later on whenever we get into, you know, the synopsis and summary of the book. But this is the toughest in spiritual sense. Characteristic that you will hold. Stay strong, build up, and stay prayed up in order to continue to be strong in God. Yeah, ladies, if you see a man fighting and trying to whatever, he is a man of valor, you know, whatever. This is the toughest thing, okay? He's trying to be hard and strong for you. Alright? Know that I love you for real, and always remember to live every day, laugh every moment, and to love God, love yourself, and love other people beyond words. For more about me or the broadcast, you can visit our website at thearch3show.com. Visit me and come back tomorrow. If I be here, I'll be here. If I don't, of course, you will have a great show lined up. Lined up for you. All right, I love you all for real, and I'll see you all when I see you all. Peace. Set me free, I'm gonna dance and there's no stopping me. Don't ever change, cause I got victory. So go ahead and praise him, cause he's been so good. Give him all the glory like you know you should. Don't worry about the day to face, can't stop you if they could. So go ahead and praise him, praise him like you.
See you later.
Cause I'm saying bye-bye.
Good night.